How's it going, guys? It's Hex here, and today I want to talk to you guys about the new Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, and what I believe myself and the rest of the Call of Duty community and other gaming communities want to see in the next Call of Duty after the kind of bitter taste that we have of Call of Duty Ghost. And hopefully this new Call of Duty can get people back into the series as it's coming out on next gen. Hopefully it's just a big Call of Duty that gets people re-into the series, and it just reinvents the whole series. Hopefully they decide to do something different besides just including mech suits into score streaks and stuff. Hopefully they can actually do something with this and actually advance the game further. Now, the first thing I think we can all agree that the next Call of Duty Advanced Warfare needs is some decent maps. Now, we don't want just reinvented maps from the other Call of Duties. If they're going to reinvent the maps, at least give them to us for free and not just pay it off as a DLC item, because we're not paying for old maps. If they really were a fan favorite, they would include them in the game with just the price tag of the game. There shouldn't be extra costs for the maps. So hopefully we can get some smaller, more fast-paced maps, which is not like we saw in Call of Duty Ghosts. Hopefully we don't get any of those big maps. I know a lot of people are saying that they're generally the same size as the other maps, but it's just the way they're set out. They're not set out for fluid gameplay. It's not fast-paced, and it's not fun. Hopefully they can definitely bring us some more innovative maps and just give us something more than just like boxes and stuff to hide behind. Give us more destruction. We saw a little bit of that in Call of Duty Ghosts, and I think a little bit more destruction will work for the Call of Duty franchise. But we don't really need to be able to blow down buildings like you can in Battlefield 4, which that would be awesome, but we don't really want to see that in Call of Duty, because that'd just be copying Battlefield. But I think we do need to see more than just the regular maps. They do need to do something that innovates the gameplay to make it more fluid and more fun. And I think we definitely need some more smaller maps after getting the giant maps of Call of Duty Ghosts. Which also leads me on to the next thing that I do want to see in the next Advanced Warfare. A lot of people had mixed opinions about this, is that's microtransactions. Now, microtransactions I do not like, but I do think one thing that Call of Duty Ghosts did very well was the DLC side of it. They had great map packs and great new camos and new weapons and stuff coming out constantly, as well as new characters and stuff. Though this wasn't taken too massively, it didn't really change the way you played or anything like that, and all the guns they released so far haven't been that great. They've all been pretty ordinary. So hopefully we do see some more weapons and new camos and stuff. But and if they do include a season pass, why don't they just include all of these microtransaction items so we don't have any more microtransactions? Because nobody wants microtransactions. It'd just be easier if they gave everybody the DLC when they actually brought the season pass, because the season pass, you're supposed to get all the DLC items, not just a couple of mac packs where they skimp on the maps and just bring you guns that are already basically in the game. It's just copies of other guns in the games with a new coding over it. So hopefully they can actually bring us the microtransactions within the DLC. But something Call of Duty Ghosts did very well, as I said, is the DLC side of it. So hopefully we can see that come into Advanced Warfare. Also, something we should definitely be hoping for, because it's coming out on next gen, and I'm not sure about, well, current gen now, I'm not sure about how it will look on last gen PS3 and Xbox 360, but definitely we want to see some better graphics. And I'm not really feeling very confident about the PS3 and Xbox 360 versions, or even the Xbox One versions, because it's the first Call of Duty officially coming out and being made for the next generation or current generation. Hopefully they can run it on a better engine, and hopefully we don't just see the same old Call of Duty graphics, because that's really getting old, and hopefully they can get us a new engine, especially coming into the next generation of gaming. Now, the next thing I want to see in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, which kind of ties in with the idea of some different maps, is just some smoother and swifter gameplay, because I don't know about you guys, but I found Call of Duty Ghosts to be really clunky and slow. It might have been because the big maps, or just the just the animations within the game, because Call of Duty Black Ops 2 was really, really swift and smooth, and the animations in the game were really, really good, if you guys kind of get what I'm saying here. But hopefully they can just bring us some smoother and swifter gameplay, because that was a big thing that hurt Call of Duty Ghosts for me. I don't think it's a bad game, it's just way too slow, and it's just not much fun to play. So hopefully they can do this and bring us some nice, fun gameplay, because Black Ops 2 was a massive hit. And all the other Call of Duties actually have had a lot more swifter gameplay than Call of Duty Ghosts. And hopefully they can just, bring us a more swifter and smoother game, which will tie in with the maps. Another thing which will tie in the maps is hopefully they can bring us a higher player count, because this is coming out on next gen. And hopefully, like Battlefield 4 did, usually for consoles, Battlefield 4 or Battlefield 3 was 32 players max. So this was 16v16 on Battlefield 3 on last gen. But when the next gen came out, they made it 64 players, which is 32v32, as well as commanders as well. So it's basically 66 max players online. Hopefully Call of Duty Advanced Warfare can do this, and hopefully bring us a higher player count, because I think it needs that. It doesn't have to increase it much, but maybe 8v8s, or maybe even 12v12s inside, just depending on the game mode and stuff like that. And hopefully they don't bring us as many game modes as they did in Call of Duty Ghost, because it just stretches out the player limit and the player count. And hopefully they can just bring us the best of the game modes. I'm not really hoping Infected comes back, because that chews up a lot of the players. Hopefully Search and Rescue is absolutely ditched, because that's one of the worst modes I've ever played. They try to glorify it and stuff. But another thing that I do want to see is Cranks from Call of Duty Ghost. That was a fantastic mode, but not enough people are playing it. As I said, the players are just being spread out because there's too many modes that people don't play. They really need to take some modes out of the game and just reinvent some of the modes to make them funner and just give you higher player counts in the modes that people actually play. Also, one other thing they really need to get right is the guns. The guns in Call of Duty Ghost, which I'll probably make a video about, were my least favorite Call of Duty guns. They are probably some of the worst guns I've ever played with, as well as the attachments. There's not much variety in attachments. It's really limited. The quality of the attachments aren't that great. They don't overly affect the gun. Some of the guns are way overpowered compared to the other guns. I think Call of Duty Advanced Warfare just needs to find a decent balance and hopefully bring us some better guns. I don't know if you guys have played Battlefield 4, but Battlefield 4 has probably the best gun range in any game that I've ever played. It's got some of my favorite guns, the P90. What else is there? There's the CZ 109, I think, as well as the F2000. They're some of the best guns in modern shooters, and hopefully they can bring these guns back, as well as the classic M4 family, as well, the M416 and M4A1. Hopefully they bring those into Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, because some of them guns were in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. So hopefully we can see those guns return, because that's some of my favorite guns. If you guys want to leave your favorite guns down below, what guns do you guys want to see in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare? Because I know I definitely need a bit of a change up from the Call of Duty Ghost guns, because there just wasn't any balance and the guns just weren't any fun to play with. Also, in the trailer, they showed off some hover bikes and stuff like that. Now, people can have mixed opinions about this, but I want to see stuff like that in multiplayer. I want to see vehicles in multiplayer. I know this is a big ask for Call of Duty, because it's just not something they do, and it just could be a massive leap in the wrong direction, but maybe specific modes that use vehicles and stuff like that, maybe on bigger maps, and as I said before, higher player counts for specific modes, maybe include some vehicles, just things like hovercrafts and stuff could be a lot of fun. Maybe even add that as a score streak, and you can actually, like, having a hovercraft, going around on a hover bike as a score streak would be absolutely amazing. Could be overpowered, but overly, I think it'd just be a lot of fun to use and muck around with, and hopefully they can bring that into multiplayer. And anyway, if it doesn't work, they can ditch that as well. I know a lot of people would hate to see vehicle playability come into multiplayer, but I think if they can bring it into the campaign, if they show it off in the campaign, hopefully they can bring it into the multiplayer some way and help make it balance and just a lot of fun. I think vehicles could work with the next generation if they get the maps and the player count right as well. Now, that's basically all for the multiplayer side of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare of what I want to see, but it's one thing that I do want to see in the single player is just some multiple choice. I want a multiple choice campaign that was like in Black Ops 2. And I just want to see you actually have an impact on how the game plays out. I just don't want like another scripted campaign, which I think this is actually looking a lot like. Hopefully you get to try to change sides. You don't have to follow the game. Maybe if someone offers you a higher amount of money, you can go fight for them, as they kind of like have showed off in the recent trailers and information that they've given. Now it looks like you're going to be fighting for multiple sides. Hopefully you can actually choose those fight sides for yourself. And even even single player loadouts was a good thing in Black Ops 2, and hopefully they can bring that back as well. I found that a lot of fun just to play around with some different guns and attachments, and just to just gives you a little bit more of a personal feel about the campaign. And hopefully they can actually give us a good story in the campaign, because Call of Duty Ghost definitely left me a bit sour. Though the campaign wasn't that bad, but I'm sure we all remember that tank mission in Call of Duty Ghost. let's try not to speak about that too much, but that was probably one of the worst missions I've ever played in a game. That's what really just, I was having a good time in the single player in Call of Duty Ghosts, but after that tank mission, it was just such a poorly made map. The tanks were just like driving around on an ATV. It was so badly designed and so badly seen through. They didn't see it through very well. And hopefully they can bring us some actually good vehicles, and it's looking really good because it looks like you're going to be fighting in kind of urban areas, which is my favorite scenes to fight in. Hopefully they can bring back kind of things like the map Estate from Modern Warfare 2. I don't really want them to remake that, but hopefully like a nice outdoorsy map like that, because that'd be a lot of fun to play on, because just taking cover behind trees and that ditch and everything, it was just a heap of fun. I'm sure you guys remember that map. It was probably one of my personal favorites from Modern Warfare 2. So anyway, that's the kind of changes and stuff I want to see in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. If you guys agree with me or have your own ideas on changes that they should make with the Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, then don't be afraid to comment them down below, and I'll definitely consider them and stuff. And hopefully we get a lot more details at E3, which will be coming around this month, so hopefully we can all get pumped for that. And I'll probably be reporting on what Sledgehammer and other publishers kind of talk about. Hopefully they give us a lot of information, and hopefully they can actually just give us a good Call of Duty, because after Call of Duty Ghosts, I'm kind of not really in the franchise. If this one's bad, then I'm completely ditching it for good, and I really don't want to do that, because Kevin Spacey is probably one of my favorite actors as currently, and hopefully they can actually just bring us a good Call of Duty. So make sure to leave your own ideas down below, and I'll see you guys all later, and bye bye.
Put it out, out, out. We can light it up, up, up. So they can put it out.